Good afternoon, sisters and brothers. To preserve the solemnity of our celebration, let us please turn off our cell phones or put them on silent mode. Thank you for your cooperation. We have some announcements. The liturgical Bible study will be canceled until June 21 while Father Francis is on pilgrimage and will resume on June 28. Everyone is invited to join the Tuesday praise and worship after the 6 p.m. Mass with music, prayer, and thanksgiving. Let us celebrate our faith and find hope in the Lord. On June 11, Sunday, the Solemnity of the Most Holy Body and Blood of the Lord, or Corpus Christi, we will have a Eucharistic procession after the 6 p.m. Mass. We would like to appeal to everyone to keep your face masks on while celebrating the Mass for everyone's protection against COVID-19. We would like to request everyone to refrain from clapping our hands at the dismissal of the Mass. After post-communion prayer, we will have a second collection for a Love a Parish program, which helps 475 parishes and charitable institutions all over the country. Thank you. For more information, you may visit the Facebook page of the chapel, Greenbelt Chapel, Santo Niño de Paz. Welcome to the Holy Sacrifice at the Mass. Today is June 4, 2023, and we celebrate the Solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. Our presider for this Holy Sacrifice at the Mass is our chaplain, Reverend Father Dave Concepcion. Please stand and let us join the choir in singing the entrance hymn.
Let us begin our celebration in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to participate in these sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins and humbly ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God, our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith we may acknowledge Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people, yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim. Praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice, mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Together, glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the one, the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You cannot find the word Trinity in the Bible. That's why those people who say sola scriptura, they only believe what is written in the Bible, then they find themselves wrong, because there are a lot of things that are not written in the Bible but being preserved in tradition by the Catholic Church. When we say tradition, we talk about the capital T. The Holy Trinity, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one and yet different, are the names we always invoke when we begin and end our prayer. The very name we invoke when we ask for healing. The very name we invoke when we are being dispensed or being absolved from our sins. Saint Augustine have said this: to believe, you need to understand. But there are things you need to believe first before you're able to understand. Bago ka maniwala, kailangan mong maintindihan. Pero minsan, kailangan mong maniwala muna bago mo maintindihan. What is the simplest explanation of the Trinity? What we profess in the Nicene Creed, in the Apostles' Creed, we profess that the Father creates, the Son redeems, the Holy Spirit sanctifies. The Father creates, the Son redeems, the Holy Spirit sanctifies. There was no point in time that the Father was present and the Son and the Spirit was absent. There was no time when the Son was present, the Father and the Spirit was absent. There was no time where the Spirit was present, the Father and the Son was absent. They are always together, different, three, but one. In simple terms, sabi nila, ano ba yun, Father? Pwede ba talaga yun? Ang pinakamadaling paliwanag ay ang isang babae sa kanyang pagkadalaga. Ang tawag mo sa kanya ay ano? Anong magbigay ta ng pangalan? Halimbawa, Marta. Marta. Pinakasalan mo si Marta. Ang tawag mo sa kanya ay darling, sweetheart, kung ano man, di po ba, no? Pero nung siya'y nagkaanak, bigla mong tinawag sa kanya, Mama. Napansin niyo ba yun? Ang tawag niya sa misis niyo, biglang naging Mama. Mama mo ba siya? Hindi. Kasi ayaw mo na yung anak mo, tawagin ang misis mo ayon sa pagkakatawag mo sa kanya. Di po ba? Tinatawag ng Mr. Halimbawa si Marta, Marta, Marta. Dala nila yung bata sa supermarket, nawala yung bata. Maya-maya may nadidinig silang batang sumisigaw, Marta! Marta! Ano po? Hinahanap pala yung nanay niya. Di po ba? No? Kaya mo tinatawag ang misis mo Mama dahil nagkaroon siya ng anak. Pero pag nagkaroon kayo ng apo, biglang ang tawag mo sa misis mo, Lola. Di po ba? Nagbago ba ang tao? Nagbago ba ang babaeng yun? Hindi. Nagbago ang kanyang role sa buhay sa mundong ito. Hindi nababago ang pagkatao. Nagbabago ang role. In the beginning, He was the Creator. Then He was the Redeemer. Then after the Pentecost, or after the Ascension, He was the Sanctifier. In more scientific way, the best way to describe the Trinity is the sun, ang araw, ang araw. Pag tinignan mo ang araw, ang nakikita mo lang ay liwanag. Pero hindi mo talaga nakikita ang araw. Pero alam mo kung anong itsura ng araw sa likod ng liwanag. Hindi po ba? Pag sinasabi ko sa inyo, nasaan ang ilaw? Ituro nyo ang ilaw, nasaan? Sabi ng babae kagabi, tayo naman, nguso ang pinagtuturo natin. Pag malapit lang, nguso, di po ba? Na? Pag malayo, daliri na, di po ba? Na? Hindi mo nakikita ang ilaw. You can never see the light. It is through the light that we are able to see. Take note, you can never see the light. It is through the light that we are able to see. So if you look at the sun, ang nakikita mo ay liwanag. Pero hindi mo nakikita yung buo na nasa likod ng liwanag. At pag ikaw ay tumayo sa ilalim ng araw, ang nararamdaman mo ay init. Nakita mo ba yung init na dumapo? Hindi. Pero hindi mo pwede paghiwalayin ang araw, ang liwanag, at ang init. They are always three, but one. Hindi mo pwedeng paghiwalayin. Kaya yung analogy na ang Holy Trinity daw ay itlog, kasi mayroong balat, may pula, at may puti. Hindi pwede yun. Bakit? Kasi pwede mong paghiwalayin eh.
Ang Trinity, hindi mo pwedeng paghiwalayin. Tayo mga Pilipino, isa sa nakakahiyang kwento tungkol sa atin pag nagpipilgrimage tayo.
Ano pa?
Mahilig tayo magbalot. Mahilig magbalot pagkatapos ng breakfast. Lahat na pwedeng balutin, binabalot. Magbabalot ng tinapay. Ang pinakamadaling ibalot, itlog na nilaga.
Ano pa?
Binabantayan nyo ng mga waiter sa sa kainan ng hotel. Ano pa? Minsan sabi nung isang waiter, "You Filipinos, you love to eat eggs." Kasi palaging ubos yung itlog eh. Ano pa? "You love to eat eggs." Sabi ng mga isabi ng isang pilgrim, "Yeah, we love to eat eggs." Naubos ang itlog, pero walang natirang balat. Sabi ng waiter, "But you also eat the shell?" Sabi ng isang Pinoy, huli na eh. Sabi na, "Yeah, it's calcium." Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, hindi yun pwedeng paliwanag sa Trinity. Ang ibang paliwanag na ginagamit ay mangga. May balat, may laman, may buto. Kinakain nyo na ba ang balat ngayon? Kinakain nyo na ba ang buto? Hindi. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, Trinity is three but one. Three different person but one. Inseparable. Kahapon, nagkakape ako. Sabi ng isang servant, "Bawal sa inyo yan, Father, at 3-1. Sabi ko, 2-1 na lang ito. 2-1. Wala itong asukal. Oo. Oh, sabi, talaga walang asukal yan. Oo. Oh, gusto ko sana sabihin, tinaktak ko muna at pinili ko yung mga asukal na ganyan. Ha? Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, pag napapaghiwalay, hindi tamang analogy yun. Pero ano po ang challenge ng Trinity sa atin? Number one, remember the words of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. We must always do things for the glory of God. Whatever you do, think, ito bang aking ginagawa? Magbibigay ba ito ng parangal sa Diyos? Because the three person in one God always complement each other. Hindi sila nag-aagawa ng role. Alam ng Ama kung kailan siya nandyan, alam kung kailan lalabas ang anak, alam kung kailan darating ang Espiritu Santo. They never compete to each other. They complement. They give glory to each other. Second, like Mary, hopefully, we always point our fingers to God, realizing and reminding ourselves that our role in this world is to do the will of God. Again, to give glory. Second, to do the will of God. Ano sabi ni Maria? Do whatever He tells you. And third, hopefully, we learn to encourage. We learn to encourage rather than discourage each other. Minsan, sabi ng isang kapatid kong pari sa seminaryo, sabi niya, "Ipagsulisit mo naman ako." Sabi ko, "Ano? Gusto ko ng malaking oven. Para saan? Para mag-bake." Ano po? Para mag-bake. Of course, nag-iisip ka, magbe-bake si Father. Ano po? Sa dinami-dami ng ginagawa. Pero, ang tawag namin dyan sa spirituality, sublimate. You learn to sublimate your energy to something productive. So, nagsulisit ako, nakabili kami ng malaking oven, at ngayon, meron kami palaging pandesal. Hindi lang siya nagmimisa, nagluluto pa ng pandesal. Ano pa? Pero kaninang umaga, biglang sabi ng isang pari, tikman mo yung banana cake. Tikman mo yung banana cake. Bawal na sa akin yung pandesal eh. Bawal na sa akin ang mga cake. Pero kanina tinikman ko, may karapatan. Ha? Lasang banana cake. Hindi po ba? Ano? Mahirap yung binigyan ka ng banana cake, lasang mango. Hindi po ba? Ano? Sabi ko, oh, masarap. Masarap. But I'm trying to say, if we learn to complement each other, each of us will try to excel in the best we can be. Kaya yung mga magulang, stop saying negative words to your children. Stop saying negative words to your children. Stop saying negative words to each other. May mga magulang na walang sinabi, huwag kang tamad, huwag kang bobo, huwag kang... Ang hilig ng mga magulang sa ganyan. Kaya ano naalala ng mga bata? Tamad sila. Hindi na sila nagsusumikap kasi sinabihan na silang tamad. Diba? Pag nagkaaway ang mag-asawa, impakta! Demonyo! Wala na akong nakukuhang kasayahan sa bahay na itong impyerno palagi. Diba? Oh, alam niyo ang kwento. Tinanong ng teacher, anong pangalan ng nanay mo? Impakta. Anong pangalan ng tatay mo? Demonyo. Saan ka nakatira? Sa impyerno. Kasi yan ang nadidinig. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, natatawa kayo, pero yan ang totoo. Di po ba? Yan ang totoo. We can never be one if we keep only taking what is good for us, our comfort. Kaya nga pag ako'y nagkakasal, palagi ko sinasabi ito sa mga mag-asawa, pag nagre-renew ng kasal, palagi ko pa rin sinasabi. Ang ano yun? Matutong mag-usap ng malumanay. Sapagkat hindi totoo na naririnig tayo kapag tayo'y nagtataas ng boses. Keep that in mind. Kapag merong sumisigaw, ibig sabihin, merong hindi nakikinig. Hello? Kapag mayroong sumisigaw, ibig sabihin mayroong hindi nakikinig. Kapag sumigaw ang nanay, ang mga anak hindi nakikinig. Di po ba? Kapag sumigaw si Mrs., si Mr. hindi nakikinig. Kaya pag sumigaw si Mr., bingi si Mrs. Ayaw nilang tanggapin, hindi sila nakikinig. No? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, think about this. We can prosper if we can complement each other. By the way, I just saw this. If you replace the word I with we, can you imagine? I with we. Hello. Then think of the word illness. I L L in ESS, illness. You replace I with we, what happened to the word? Ang galing nyo. My dear friends, if we take away ourselves and we become we will have a better world. Amen. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, having received from the Blessed Trinity the gifts of life and faith, let us approach the throne of glory, pleading for the needs of all mankind. And every petition, let our response be, O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
For the entire Catholic Church, God's family on earth, may she proclaim with her teaching and make present with her initiatives the love of the Blessed Trinity for all human beings. Let us pray.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
For the Holy Father, our bishops, and our parish priests, may they be constantly strengthened in the fulfillment of their pastoral duty and see the fruits of their dedication. Let us pray.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
For all the members of the different Christian denominations, may their common faith in the Blessed Trinity bring them to live in unity, cooperation, and peace. Let us pray.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
For all families in our parish, may the harmony and love that bind together the three divine persons be reflected in the mutual relationships of all the members of each family. Let us pray.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
For ourselves and all people dear to us, may we always be aware of the presence of the Blessed Trinity in our midst and derive from it joy, courage, and inspiration. Let us pray.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
Let us now pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray.
O Most Holy Trinity, hear us.
Eternal Triune God, you created us in your image and give us new life in your sacrament of baptism. Fill our lives with your presence and welcome us into your kingdom where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that the sacrifice of yours and mine be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for good and the good of all His holy church.
Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it, make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We'll lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity and substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, gave you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave you thanks. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity,
together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, all the bishops and all the clergy. Father, please hear the prayers of your children gathered here before your holy presence. Let's spend a few moments of silence, and I invite you, brothers and sisters, that you personally ask the Lord for a special grace you want to receive in this Eucharistic celebration. Ask the Lord. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Padre Pio Petrocina, and all the saints of Lisieux throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Gathering all our prayers into one, let us now pray to the Father in the very words our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Lord, we pray from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all unnecessary worries and distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," kindly look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace within our hearts, peace in our mind, peace in our own homes, in our own families, peace in our workplace, peace in our community, peace in our country and in the world. And grant unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, the peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now bless one another by giving each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
My dear brothers and sisters, this is Jesus, the God who redeems, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are you who are invited here to receive Him in Holy Communion.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. For a solemn reception of communion, we will do it row by row. Please follow the guidance of our ushers. For those outside the chapel, extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion will be stationed near the bridges to distribute Holy Communion. Kindly form two lines before them.
Paalala lang po sa lahat, the moment you receive the body of Christ, consume it in front of the minister. Huwag niyo pong dadalhin sa upuan. Ano po? Consume it in front of the lay minister. Thank you.
Holy Spirit, unite.
Let us pray the prayer of Padre Pio Petrocina. Stay with me, Lord, for it is necessary to have your presence so that I do not forget you. You know how I easily abandon you. Stay with me, Lord, because I am weak and I need your strength, that I may not fall so often. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my life, and without you I am in darkness. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my light, and without you I am in darkness. Stay with me, Lord, to show me your will. Stay with me, Lord, so that I hear your voice and follow you. Stay with me, Lord, for I desire to love you very much and always be in your company. Stay with me, Lord, if you wish me to be faithful to you. Stay with me, Lord, for as poor as my soul is, I want it to be a place of consolation for you, a nest of love. Stay with me, Jesus, for it is getting late and the day is coming to a close, and life passes, death, judgment, eternity approaches. It is necessary to renew my strength so that I will not stop along the way, and for that I need you. It is getting late and death approaches. I fear the darkness, the temptation, the dryness, the cross, the sorrows. Oh, how I need you, my Jesus, in this night of exile. Stay with me tonight, Jesus, in life with all its dangers, I need you. Let me recognize you as your disciples did at the breaking of the bread, so that the Eucharistic communion be the light which disperses the darkness, the force which sustained me, the unique joy of my heart. Stay with me, Lord, because at the hour of my death, I want to remain united to you, if not by communion, at least by grace and love. Stay with me, Jesus. I do not ask for divine consolation because I do not merit it, but the gift of your presence, oh yes, I ask this of you. Stay with me, Lord, for it is you alone I look for. Your love, your grace, your will, your heart, your spirit, because I love you and ask no other reward but to love you more and more. With a firm love, I will love you with all my heart while on earth, and continue to love you perfectly during all eternity. Amen. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please all be seated. We will now have a second collection for our Love of Paris program. Grindel Chapel regularly supports the works of charity and truth of our 475 poor parishes and other beneficiaries like Caritas of Manila, the Missionaries of Charity of Mother Teresa, Little Sisters of the Poor, Missionaries of the Poor, Tulay ng Kabataan, Radyo Veritas, and TV Maria. We are also helping contemplatives like the Poor Clares and Carmelites all over the country who are praying for our intentions. Thank you very much for your valuable support. Every amount you give goes a long way in sustaining this mission. May God continually bless your generous hearts.
More wonderful than any gift you bring. My treasure is you. There's no other. My treasure is you. More than gold, heaven and earth, they have lost their luster. You alone are the treasure that I hold.
Maraming salamat po. I just would like to take the opportunity on this first Sunday to bless all those who are celebrating their birthday for this month of June. Kung kayo po ay birthday June, may invite you in front so we can pray for you. Birthday ng June. Dito sa harapan, ano po, June, birthday, hindi June bride, ah. Birthday. Bata, matanda, may ipin o wala. Dito po sa harap, lapit po kayo. Wala na. Ipagdasal po natin na silang lahat ay umaman. Huwag na kayong mabol, ha? Atin po ito ng ating mga kamay tungo sa kanila. Tingin natin ang pagpapala ng Diyos na manahan sa kanila. Ama naming mapagmahal, idinudulog po namin sa iyo. Ito yung mga anak narito sa aming harapan. Taglay ang kanilang mga pasasalamat sa biyaya ng buhay na pinagkaloob mo sa kanila. Kung saan sa buwang ito ng Hunyo ay kanya-kanya nilang ipagdiriwang ang kanilang mga kapanganakan. Kilala mo sila, Panginoon, ikaw ang nagbigay ng buhay, ikaw ang nagtaguyod. Alam mo ang kanilang mga pinagdaanan at pinagdadaanan ngayon. Hindi lihim sa iyo ang kanilang mga pagtawa at pagluha, kahinaan at kalakasan, mga kabiguan, tagumpay. Alam mo rin ang kanilang mga pangarap, hindi lang para sa kanilang mga sarili, kundi para sa kanilang mga mahal sa buhay. Lukuban mo po sila ng iyong banal na espiritu. Nawa po'y palagi mo silang ingatan. Ilayo mo sila sa lahat ng uri ng kapahamakan. Patuloy mo silang pagkalaban ng kalakasan, kalusugan, at kung meron man sa kanilang may karamdaman, sa makapangyarihang pangalan ni Jesus na taga Nazareth, pagkalaban mo sila ng kagalingan. Gabayan mo sila sa kanilang mga iniisip at ginagawa. Kung meron man silang pinagdadaan ng suliranin o problema, tuwangan mo sila, alisin mo po ang kanilang mga pagkatakot at pangamba. Dagdagan mo po ang kanilang mga pananalig at pananampalataya sa iyo. Birthday nila, Lord, kayo na po magregalo. Kung ano man ang higit na makabubuti, makababanal, makasasaya, makauunlad, makasasagana ng kanilang mga buhay, kayo na po ang magbigay. Nawa po sa tulong at panalangin mga banal, lalong-lalo po ng mahal na Birhen, gayon din ni San Jose, tapat niyang esposo, at aming patron, Padre Pio ng Petrocina. Pagpalain mo po ang bawat isa, nagdiriwang ng karawan, nandito sa harapan, gayon din kasama namin sa online, sa ngalan ng Ama, Anak, at Espiritu Santo.
Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. May you have many more happy birthdays to come. Dito sa Greenbelt, ang target po dito makaabot ng 101. 101. Okay, pakainin nawa kayo ng inyong mga mahal sa buhay. Going back to what I've said, a simple analogy. If you replace I with we, your illness will become your willness. Yes? Simple lang, pero maganda, no? Ha? Sana sa tahanan, yung tayo, hindi ako lang.
mahirap yung ikaw lang nagmamasakit. Sana lahat. Hindi po ba, anak? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, if we can encourage everyone rather than discourage, we will have a better world, a better life, a better church. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, sisters and brothers, for coming to celebrate the Mass with us. May we all have a grace-filled day.